So today I am going to give you an introduction about digital transformation, virtual construction using BIM technology. That's the presentation overview. So I have pointed total 10 numbers of main thing here. So I'll be going through one by one. First of all, introduction to the practical field of construction industry. What is going on in the current trend and what is going on in the current industries in the practical field? So I'll give you a small introduction about that. So second thing is digital revolution, transformation in the construction industry. How we are adopting the digital transformation technology into the construction industries, that I am going to explain in that point. So coming to the next one, ongoing market trend. So in this, you can see what is going on in the market now and how we are transforming ourselves. Fourth one is what is BIM? That is the main motto here. What is BIM? BIM actually stands for Building Information Modeling. So I'll give you a brief introduction about that inside. Fifth one is benefit and purpose of BIM. Why we are using BIM in construction? So that is the most important. So that I'll give you a brief introduction in that. So sixth is various BIM software. What all are BIM software? What all are BIM leader in the market? So that I'll be presenting in that point. Seventh one is BIM opportunity in the market. If we're going to learn something, we need to see and we need to understand why you are going to learn. So that opportunity in the market right now, it is day by day, it is increasing. So I'm going to explain how it is increasing and what is the end of that. And the eighth point is expand our role beyond the possibilities with Tekla Structure. So Tekla Structure is one of the most important BIM software in the market. You can say it is one of the most leading software which presently current companies, it means all the companies are using. So that I will explain using Tekla Structure, how we can expand our role. Ninth one is digital twin concept in construction market. Digital twins means what you are modeling inside the room, that is similar, it is building at site. So that's digital twin concept. I'll give you a brief introduction inside that. And last one is our role in the industries. As a civil engineer, what we can do for the industries and for the societies. First of all, introduction to the practical field of construction. As you all know, construction is an important sector that contributes greatly to the economic growth of a nation. The construction industry is an investment-led sector where government shows very, very high interest in that. So always government is releasing contract with construction industry to develop infrastructure related to health, transportation, as well as the education sector. You can see in different news journal and various news channel, the construction industry expected to record a compound annual growth rate, that is CAGR, of 15.7% to reach $738.5 billion by 2020. You can easily understand what is the possibilities in the coming future. Here we have total main different construction sector. There is three number sector we have divided. First of all, it is building. So in the building, high-rise building, malls are there. Second of all, infrastructure, where government is giving, it means more priority. That is roadways, highways, bridge, JT. These kind of things government is funding right now. And third one is industrial. Industrial means all the power generation, like the steel plant, power plant, solar power, thermal power is less right now. But nuclear power, government is giving more effort in that. This is the continuation of the different phase of construction and life cycle. We have total three life cycle categories, that is design phase, build phase, operate phase. So all build construction follows the three phase concept, each construction project. It's important to understand the detail of the process. The three phase follows a design, construction, and operate, all are back to back. So in design phase, what actually it is happening? A project starting with figuring out the scale of work, which determines the project cost and provide enough information to give a beginning of estimate. So first, we need to understand the project cost and we need to embed the enough information inside that so that all the companies can bid for that project. Cost is an important consideration. All will experience in managing the budget, meet the customer requirements. all the companies, what they are focusing to meet the customer requirement. So once the beginning estimate accepted, the schedule, material selection, construction method finalized, budget and contract are provided based on the complete plan and specification for the project. So now I can tell you how it's happened. So in the design phase, you can see first we have to do a conceptual design to showcase what we are going to build. To whom we have to showcase? We have to showcase our conceptual design to the client. So then after approval of this, we are going to do for the detailed design of this project. Then after the detailed design, so we have to analyze this thing, whether it can be stable or not. After analyzing, we are doing the documentation. Documentation means you have to do for that modeling as well as the drawings which is coming from the model. So that is the documentation. So now in the next phase of construction is a build phase. Before the project starts, material and check to ensure they are readily available Iceland and that special order item then to drive within the required lifetime. So we need to understand before the construction phase, all the materials which is needed for this construction, it can be readily available. Once work started on the project, all build focus communication clearly with the customer throughout the construction process to keep the project running smoothly. So in the build phase, through this beam, what we can do, we can fabricate all the element inside the beam and the sequence so that it can be easily buildable at site without any hindrance, any delay at site. And we can do also the construction sequencing 4D, 5D. So I'll go explaining 4D and 5D in the latest slide. Okay, so it is some vast. Next is operate. After build the project, we need to operate. Operation and maintenance is one of the most important phases in construction sector. After handed over to the project to the client, the main challenge is to operate the project 100% efficient. We are going to build something for a special purpose, like for a power plant. I can say we are going to build this power plant to generate the electricity. So after construction phase, when we are handed over to the client this power plant, so client has to do, it means all the possibility has to explore the all the possibility to gain 100% efficiency from this power plant. Coming to the next slide, digital revolution transformation in the construction industries. So broadly, a digital transformation involves two types of changes. One is business model innovation, whereby the companies introduce digitally enabled product and service. You can see this term digitally enabled. In the current construction market, beam is the only one wheel where we can base the digital transformation. Then the next one is a operational improvement, whereby the companies apply advanced technologies and the way of working enhance the development, the delivery of project. So it means advanced technology and way of working also we can change throughout the beam. So you can see in 1985 or 90, we were doing 2D pencil sketch. Then we come to a 2D CAD drawing, which is AutoCAD. Then we came to a 3D CAD model. In the 3D CAD model, we were modeling only the element. There was no information, much more information, only element, beam, column, slab, we were modeling, right? Then we thought we need to embed something into the model where we can get all those information together in a box, in a platform. So then we come into 3D beam model. 3D beam itself, we are not building only the element. We are not modeling only the element. We are modeling information. So building information modeling, we are modeling information also. We are currently in the beam 3D model, this stage. We are slowly moving into the 4D model. So what is 4D? Can ask me, what is 4D? We know only the 3D. 4D is a time constant. We can do the sequencing in that. Sequencing means after 3D model, the project management team will do a P6 Primavera model where you can get all the information about that. It means fabrication and construction. Means how much time it will take to construct or fabricate at site. So that sequencing we can do inside the Beam. It's a collaborative platform of 3D model and Primavera Basic. And the coming future, we are going to do one more thing, that is 5D Beam model. 5D means cost implementation also we can do with the Beam. So you can easily understand this process. What we are going to do is a single platform, not different platforms. In a single platform, everything will be there, easily handled. So now we are in this phase, level 2 to 3 in line here. So still lot more to go. So in this phase, what we are doing in a content 3D building object, requirement to the object properties and ID. We are modeling one 3D object where properties and ID is there for each and every object. Then digitalization. From this 3D model, we are extracting drawings and view standardization, mobile device and limited paper use. So what we are doing now, we have already started to use the limited number of printed drawings. So here we are extracting the IFC file. In that IFC file, you can load that IFC file in your tab at site or in your mobile at site, so that you can easily understand, it means what you are going to build at site. You can explain your site skill level, how we have to install, how you need to bind the rod like that. Then interoperability. So this is the main thing. This IFC file, which we are creating from the Beam software, it can be accepted by the overall global, all the platform. Means all the software like Navisworks, then Beam site, these kind of things, as well as all the devices. And then interface. Most about interface is to handle the advanced simulation and integrated project delivery system. You can understand we are currently standing here. Still, we need to go here and then into the level 4, means where you can get all the things 4D and 5D. Next one, ongoing market trends. This is most important part here. So as you all know, the government is focusing to increase the infrastructure in all sector like building, industries and power generation. The latest trend in construction industry to take technology advantage, integration, adapting green technology in construction. Green technology means we need to reduce as much as possible our waste, first of all, in the construction. So increase the modular and prefabricated construction into project. So if you increase your prefabricated construction element into your project, then you can reduce your cost and you can reduce the construction waste also. The technology advantage, how you are adapting. The real example of the technology advantage indicates is Beam. The main motto is to integrate all discipline under one roof. Using Beam, you can do it in a better manner from the design phase to commissioning phase. So what you can do in this, you can take all the discipline, means you have the civil discipline, structural discipline, mechanical, electrical, plumbing, instrumentation, all the discipline you can bring under one roof, where everyone can see your model, where everyone can find the problem, what you have done in your model. So everyone can rectify their problem itself there. So that is the advantage. And the green technology in construction, as you all know, everyone is running behind the Go Green concept. It actually means the reduce waste as much as possible and save our earth. So using Beam technology, you can reduce your waste. And using Beam, you can reduce the construction waste. You can estimate your construction material 99% perfect. So can you imagine the construction industry has the big problem of construction waste, where all the companies spending lot of money to construction waste only. So if we can reduce our construction waste using the Beam technology, that would be the best, it means biggest achievement. And the third one is modular and prefabricated construction. Construction, predict the modular construction will continue to the growth by 6.9% per year and hit $157 billion by 2023. You can see that figure. You can search in anywhere in the Google. You can get that figure. where we are going to, it means going to the end. There is no end actually. Coming to the next slide, you can, I think you can understand the ongoing market trends here. Then coming to the next one, what is BIM? It stands for Building Information Modeling. It's an intelligent 3D model based on the process, give architectural, engineering, and construction. All the discipline, all the stages, you can use your 3D BIM information modeling system. So it is more efficient. You can do plan, design, construction, and manage your building and infrastructure. Everything you can do with the BIM. So you can easily see 3D. 3D means 3D model and drawings you can produce. And you can do the sequencing time, 4D, so that you can easily understand how much time it will take to finish your construction. And it means after finishing, you need to hand over to the client. So that time you can give it to your client also. And the cost is the major it means role here. So if you reduce your cost, and if you it means hold your cost within your hand, then you can do whatever you want. So in the 5D, you can hold your cost also. You can easily understand how much cost it will, how much cost required for that. And 6D, this is it means it is very long away. 60 is, it's linked to building management. Building management means asset management. Inside the building, so many assets are there. You can manage your asset through this 6D. Here, you can see one by one, documentation. You can, through this BIM, you can do, first of all, documentation. Appropriately name and the place of the CD. CD means common data environment. In the common data environment, you can put your data. The architectural guys put their data. Mechanical people can put their data. Everything you can put in a, it means in a safe manner, you can say. In a safe manner, you can documentation your project. That information closely connect to the 3 model, allowing them to easily found and accurate. You can, where you are putting your data, you can easily find. Anyone can find. If you are not there, then someone else can do that one. This is the advantage. And the 3D model carries the information and dependency object among each other. So where it will be, you can put all those things inside the 3D model. You can print your drawing itself from there. Anything you can do with the 3D model. So it can be views from the site. It can be views from the project management team. It can be views from your manager also.